Welcome to Books and Company. Bienvenidos todos. I'm your host, Alberto Rios, and we're joined today by Greg Iles talking about his wonderful book, The Bone Tree. It's a tour de force, that is to say, part of a tour de force, The Middle Child. This is part of a trilogy. And I wonder, when you're writing something that's in the middle, you're neither at the beginning, nor are you wrapping things up. How does that feel to you as a writer, where you know you can't give too much away, and yet you got to build stuff up? And
think how it feels as a publisher. That's that's why that's why convincing a publisher to do this was such a challenge. You know, the first book has no end, the second book has no beginning or end, and the third book has no beginning. It's it's tough, and that's why I think the format doesn't exist really in the adult mainstream fiction. And to be honest, I lost my first publisher when I made the decision to go this way. And it was only because of the sort of good faith of William Morrow, HarperCollins, to say, if you say this is the best thing you've ever done, we're willing to take a chance and give you the chance to do this. But I don't want to sound negative, Alberto, but commercial novelists like me can tell you, all the pressures in our business are to basically reproduce whatever was the last thing that made money. That's why you see so many series with the same character again and again and again. And it's a sad thing, I think, because some very talented writers end up repeating themselves to the point that it's diluted down. And corporations, by their very nature, are not geared to take risks. So it's a sad thing that in a creative field like writing is essentially governed in a way by corporations.
Yeah, and you're really envisioning this as these three as one book, I think.
Absolutely. Right? I mean, I would say Tolkien would have said the same thing about The Lord of the Rings. This book is the Two Towers. I don't think that it's essentially weakened by where it is, but there's no doubt you just have to take a cleaver and say, here's the border that makes it sellable in a book rack, you know?